Decianus couldn't afford to remove his legion from Skaven in case Lady Aurinelia continued her northern advance. But if Carmina and Kaelin could convince Sentinel to use their own forces to break the siege of Hagath, the combined armies of Sentinel, Hagath, and the Legion might be enough to halt Aurinelia's advance. The operation was a long shot, as it required the forebear city of Sentinel to rescue the crown city of Hagath. But Decianus saw no other option, and Carmina and Kaelin agreed. The two traveled to Sentinel together, further growing their bond. And thanks to Carmina's years of history with Sentinel intelligence, she successfully brokered the attack. In the first month of the year 173, Sentinel's army arrived at Hagath, broke Aurinelia's siege, and rescued the Crown forces, who then joined Sentinel on a desperate march to rejoin Decianus' legion in Skaven before Aurinelia could commence her attack. With Hagath and Sentinel controlling the Iliac Bay, the Crown and Forebear armies had a significant lead on Lady Aurinelia, whose armies still had to cross the Alakir Desert. And so Kaelin and Carmina rejoined Decianus in Skaven 1 month before the arrival of Aurinelia's army. With the Legion and the armies of Sentinel and Hagath under his command, Decianus clashed with Aurinelia in one of the bloodiest battles of the Great War. Aurinelia eventually forced Decianus from the city, but her army suffered heavy casualties and its advance into Hammerfell was successfully halted. Decianus' combined forces had also suffered major casualties, and so they retreated into the Dragontail Mountains to lick their wounds and prepare for a counterattack. Carmina and Kaelin survived the defense alongside Decianus, and for the next year, the three worked together to prepare the remaining forces for the retaking of Skaven. But just before the battle was set to take place, Decianus was ordered to march for Cyrodiil to help retake the Imperial City. Unwilling to abandon Hammerfell completely, Decianus released a great number of quote-unquote invalids from his legion before marching east for Cyrodiil. These invalids were in fact a cohort of veteran soldiers led by Kaelin, who chose to stay in Hammerfell and fight with Carmina to liberate Skaven. By this point, Kaelin and Carmina had fallen deeply in love. The strength and spirit of Carmina and her people had restored Kaelin's faith in what the Empire fought to protect, and he finally understood what his mother meant when she told him to live for himself and what he believed. In turn, Kaelin had restored Carmina's faith in what a Legion soldier could be, and she fell in love with his compassion and sense of duty to the weak and the innocent, and she was moved by his sacrifice in defending her homeland instead of his own. In the final months of year 174, Carmina, Kaelin, and their joint army of Legion veterans and Redguard freedom fighters drove Aurinelia's army out of Skaven and back across the Alakir Desert. This marked the turning point in the war against the Thalmor, and early on in the following year, the Imperial City was retaken by the combined forces of General Decianus of Hammerfell, General Yana of Skyrim, and Emperor Titus Mead II himself. This daring operation was known as the Battle of the Red Ring, and it was the last formal battle of the Great War. Later that year, a peace treaty known as the White Gold Concordat was co-signed by the Empire and the Aldmeri Dominion. This was a bittersweet resolution for the Empire, as the treaty heavily favored the Thalmor, and required, among other conditions, that the Thalmor be allowed to keep the territory they'd captured in southern Hammerfell. This condition was unacceptable to the Redguards, and both the Crowns and the Forebears stood united in rejection of the Concordat. As a result, the Emperor released Hammerfell from the Empire, a choice that many Redguards viewed as a betrayal. Hammerfell became an independent state and continued to fight the Dominion. For Kaelin and Carmina, Hammerfell's secession was a bitter pill to swallow, but they both understood that the Empire's forces were devastated, and that the Emperor couldn't risk reigniting open conflict over the violation of the Concordat. However, neither Kaelin nor Carmina had any plans to relinquish the territory they'd fought so hard to reclaim, and so they recommitted themselves to driving the Thalmor out of Hammerfell with little to no support from the Empire. For the next 5 years, the Forebears and the Crowns stood as one against the Thalmor, and finally, in the year 180 of the Fourth Era, the two sides had fought each other to a bloody stalemate, resulting in the Second Treaty of Stros-Mackay and the full withdrawal of the Dominion's military from Hammerfell. The province was devastated, but it was also free of Thalmor control after almost a decade of bitter fighting. Carmina and Kaelin were forever changed by what they'd experienced in the Great War. With both entering their twilight years, the two soldiers had learned firsthand what the cost of freedom could be, having lost so many friends and loved ones over the course of the war. There were times when they questioned whether anything could be worth so much devastation and the loss of so many lives, but they always maintained hope that their fight was just and necessary, and they always believed that a group like the Thalmor, predicated on racial superiority, must be stopped for a free world to persist. After the war ended in the 180th year of the Fourth Era, Carmina and Kaelin finally had a moment to rest, and they settled in Carmina's home city of Tanith. 1 year later, in the year 181, the couple gave birth to fraternal twins, their daughter Rhienna and their son Raethan. Like their parents before them, Raethan and Rhienna grew up among aristocracy. Kaelin and Carmina were, after all, famous generals from the Great War, and both were still hard at work overseeing the recovery of Hammerfell after the war's devastation. Kaelin and Carmina were very busy, but they tried their best to be present for their children, and so Raethan and Rhienna grew up with a strong bond to their parents, as Kaelin and Carmina had. From a young age, Rhienna was sweet and tempered like her father, while Raethan was mischievous and spirited like his mother. And though the two kids often fought as siblings do, Rhienna and Raethan were both good kids who grew up close. It was important to both parents that Rhienna and Raethan were not overly sheltered from the realities of Hammerfell's history, and so the children were sometimes allowed to shadow their parents during their difficult work of rebuilding Hammerfell society. When Raethan and Rhienna were teens, Kaelin and Carmina sat their children down and spoke to them directly about their experiences as soldiers in the Great War. As compassionately as they could, Kaelin and Carmina tried to warn their children about the threat still posed by the Thalmor, and while the ever-thoughtful Rhienna took these warnings seriously, for Raethan, the danger felt far away, as danger often does for teenagers who think themselves invincible. Unfortunately, both children received a devastating reality check shortly after their 18th birthday, when the Thalmor attempted to assassinate the entire family in a carefully organized operation that would change everyone's lives forever. One fateful night in Tanith, Kaelin received an urgent communication from Carmina, who at the time was in Sentinel meeting with the new government. According to Carmina's letter, she had narrowly survived an attempt on her life by assassins she believed were sent by the Thalmor, and she had also learned that there would be a simultaneous attack on Kaelin and the children. Carmina implored Kaelin to grab the children and execute their escape plan, a secret exfiltration from Tanith aboard the merchant ship Vespara, which was captained by a woman named Sabira, a childhood friend of Carmina's. Unfortunately, the assassins had already breached the walls of the Voss estate, and Kaelin sacrificed himself so that Raethan and Rhienna could escape. The children arrived at the Vespara as planned, and the ship immediately set sail for Sentinel, where Carmina planned to meet them, according to a letter she'd sent to Sabira. However, when the Vespara arrived in Sentinel after several months at sea, Carmina was nowhere to be found, and Sabira was unable to make contact through their regular channels. Sabira knew that the assassination attempt would not have been possible unless the new government had been compromised by Thalmor informants, and without knowing the extent of the treachery, Sabira executed one of Kaelin and Carmina's contingency plans and set sail for the Skyrim city of Windhelm, one of the few places in Tamriel that was difficult for the Thalmor to survey. The journey took almost 2 years and was horrendous for Rhienna and Raethan, who were unaccustomed to life at sea and were grieving the loss of their parents and their former life. The only thing they had was Sabira and each other, and in a cruel twist of fate, Rhienna was struck with a severe illness and died only a month before the Vespara made landfall in Windhelm. Sabira did what she could to situate Raethan in his new home, but she couldn't stay long without delaying her shipments, potentially alerting the Thalmor of her unscheduled stop. And so she left Raythan on his own, with the promise to return as soon as she could. This is where our story takes place. We are Raythan Voss, the 20-year-old lost son of Tanith, setting foot for the first time in an alien country, alone, angry, and scared, without our sister, our parents, or anyone we've ever known. Though we don't realize it now, this is where our life truly begins. And what awaits us here in Skyrim, no one could have anticipated.